To understand why so many Republicans have abandoned democracy, to see why so many believe the big lie, to get why so many are trying to rewrite voting rules, you have to hear the poisonous propaganda.
The human capacity for self-deception is tremendous.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Drone Tech, and I'm just gonna get right into this one. 10 seconds into this clip, and this human potato mutant has already spewed 3 lies. Trust me, he's just getting started.
To understand why so many Republicans have abandoned democracy, to see why so many believe the big lie, to get why so many are trying to rewrite voting rules, you have to hear the poisonous propaganda.
First lie, that Republicans, and generally anybody that disagrees with Mr. Potato here, has abandoned democracy. What exactly is this walking bratwurst idea of democracy? One party rule held up by state party propaganda? Never questioning authority as long as it's in the right party?
Yeah, pretty much.
The big lie in this case is that Biden didn't win the election and is illegitimate. If that's the standard for abandoning democracy, then Brian Stelter himself and the rest of the Democrat state media have been doing this for my entire adult life, going back to George W. Bush. In fact, it seems like any election that Democrats lose is illegitimate in the eyes of Democrats and their media. The media adores Stacey Abrams, a black female Democrat, in large part because she's never conceded her election loss in Georgia and has always claimed it was stolen.
Good morning. We're showing this mural of Stacey Abrams because it seems timely. This is clearly Stacey Abrams' moment.
Lastly, on this point, Stelter claims that the GOP is trying to, quote, rewrite voting rules, being as intentionally vague as he possibly can. Who's rewriting any of the voting rules outside the people who made up new rules for the 2020 election based on coronavirus? Does Stelter not know that the vast majority of Americans support voting IDs and these voting ID laws have existed in Democrat states like Delaware for a long time? All right, there's a lot more to mock here, but first take 30 seconds to check out this free offer for my viewers. There's a 5,000-year-old asset that's seen off every world crisis there ever was and thrived. Gold and precious metals. The oldest hedge against inflation and disaster. Your stability insurance. Take out an IRA with Noble Gold this month. And along with first-class service, they're gifting a 1/10 ounce gold bullion American Eagle coin. You can find out more by visiting the link in the description or pinned comment, or simply go to their website at www.noblegoldinvestments.com, or you could even call them at 877-646-5347. Make sure to tell them Drone Tech Politics sent you.
So, that's what we did this week. We watched every episode of Sean Hannity's show, and we color-coded it. As you can see, we focused on his language, the insults and phrases that he repeats every night. Nasty little words like these.
Oh, nasty little words, huh? This bulbous shaved monkey thinks that he's some sort of information minister. That's some creepy authoritarian shit right there. I mean, if he was just criticizing him, that's one thing, but his goal is clearly to remove and demonize Hannity from the airwaves. In fact, he wants everybody not towing the line to be silenced.
Socialist stalker, weak failure, shameless, psychotic indoctrination, hell holes.
And that's just the beginning.
What the hell is that?
God, he can't be serious. Did he just clip out individual words, removing the context from an hour-long show? It's the words that he's using that need to be silenced. This can't be real. I mean, I know we all knew that we're in trouble, but holy shit.
And that's just the beginning. On Hannity's show, President Biden is President Sippy Cup. Biden's a weak, frail, cognitive mess, Hannity says, yet the Democratic Party is portrayed as an existential threat. This is what I really wanted to ask you. You mentioned your kids. You have a daughter going into kindergarten. I have a daughter going into pre-K. And I think to myself, what kind of country is this going to be when they are our age? Do you fear that? Given the craziness we're seeing from the GOP, do you fear that for our kids, your kids and mine?
You literally just started your show by claiming the GOP was an existential threat to democracy. You spent 4 years making that claim. You yourself claimed that Trump was a Russian agent. One thing is for sure though, his ratings are plummeting. And this must be some sort of last-ditch desperate attempt to stay relevant.
That's poison. Dark, dire language is fundamentally authoritarian. It softens the ground for a movement like Stop the Steal, you know, Trump's ploy to actually steal the election. It portrays anyone who disagrees as not legitimate, as not American. Hannity is spouting something else. Hannity is spouting poison. Denouncing democratic norms like a free press, That's poison.
Democratic norms require that we have a free press that holds both parties to account. Not just one party, not the party that the majority of people in the media right now are in opposition to. Democrats have been in full control for almost 7 months now, and still the focus continues to constantly be on their political opposition and critics. All right, folks, thanks for joining me on this brain damage inducing fact check of a talking potato. If you enjoyed this, please share, like, and let me know what you think in the comments. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all tomorrow.